First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. The game's first play produces 6 yards. Brings up second down. From the 35, back to work on second and four. McCaffrey on the counter. And not much doing. He'll get this only up to about the 36. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a third and three.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you're playing strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively. And a throw there going to be incomplete. So the defense able to get off the field here on third down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on third down? That's a nice start for them in this one.
He was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. And that hits at the 6 and carries into the end zone for a touchback.
20-yard line.
And they'll come out with a 3 tight end look on the first play of the drive. Play fake. Here's Love. And he finds a man with a crossing route. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards.
And the Lions first down.
From up near the 40 now after the big play to start, here's another first and 10. First carry for Raheem Mostert. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue? Just make sure you feed me the football. And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries. Just keep giving it to him.
Pushing forward for 3 up to the 48.
By Brian Byrne.
Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Brandon, what were they thinking on defense there? That looked like they were playing for the pass. That was third and short. Yeah, it was an easy pickup because they handed it to him. That was way too easy.
Just looked like absolute confusion defensively. Not sure why they were in that set.
Yeah, I'd say you ought to have a few men in the box.
He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 25 yards there on the catch and run.
I think the good offensive coordinators of the league now are looking at the fullback position and finding the right guys to hide in that spot and increase their passing game.
That he's going to go down. Back at the 27-yard line, he sacked. Shaq Thompson making his presence felt on the sack. Protection certainly going to need to be a bit better here on second and 16. Mostert. And they won't fare much better here as he maybe gets back to the line. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up.
And it's third down.
Out of the shotgun, it's Love. Got his man complete over the middle. It's James. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. It's a gain of 22 as we tick towards 2:22 on the clock. 5 yards from the end zone, first and goal. And he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. 5 yards, a good run there, and now second and goal.
And Brandon, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise. This close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
They'll run it with Johnson. And he's going to be shoved back short of the goal line. They're held again, and do we have a goal line stand brewing? It's third and goal. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. They'll run with Mostert. And he's going to take it in for a Lion touchdown. Raheem Mostert, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Lions are going to take a first quarter lead. Now Matt Prater for the point after. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went three and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion, guys a little bit jumpy.
You
understand the same way. It's just like us calling one, right? Making sure we ease into the game, let it come to us.
Well, you went three and out.
And now to have that opportunity.
No, you didn't go three and out. I went three and out on that first drive. I'll try to do better here. That'll be caught by his tight end, Ian Thomas. 11 yards there, first down.
The goal for any offense versus a zone defense, find the holes where guys are available and put the ball in the receiver before any defender can step up and fill it.
They did it well there. Perfectly executed crossing route. Curtis Samuel, the intended target, but it's going to be second down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well and that one's incomplete.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. They'll throw again. Brissett. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
And now the third down throw incomplete as well.
That looks like it's going to be two empty possessions now to start this football game. I think they're going to have to sit down and talk about what worked for them last week in their win. Sometimes you over game plan, overthink things, get back to what works.
Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. And a great job here. This is going to turn out to be a beauty. This is marked down at about the 3-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. On the ground, it's Mostert to start the drive. And he'll find a little space. He gets this up near the 10. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
I think they're ahead of schedule now after that run. They might be bold with this second down call after that type of a game.
And he'll be hit and dropped for a loss at the 5-yard line. Chalk that up as a 4-yard loss. And now it's third down. Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. 6-0 our score after one. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown, that's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand? and forcing a three and out and giving the ball back to their offense.
It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10.
At their own.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice, so they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. From the gun, here's Brissett. This one complete to Curtis Samuel. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. 15 yards on the play, first down.
10 at the 44-yard line.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3.
He's brought down at the 37-yard line.
On second down, McCaffrey. And he's going to get it down to the 33-yard line here. 4 yards the pickup, first down. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Off the play fake, here's Brissett. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Julian Okwara in there to record the second sack of his young NFL career. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. From the shotgun, it's Brissett. He's going to look deep for more. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Out of the gun, Brissett. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. Detroit was up for the challenge through the air. They force a fourth down.
Well, when you've got a tight end who can run, you've got to give him a shot to unlock the defense. Want to see what they can get, taking the big shot downfield. That one winds up incomplete.
Joey Sly on now for the Panthers. This from 54 yards away. And his kick is good. He just did tuck it into the bottom of that left corner. And they are on the board, trailing now 6-3. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. To throw now, here's Love. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And he'll take this across the 25 before going out of bounds.
Number 46.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But doesn't matter what you call the position, it's who you put there. And there we saw a completion.
It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They run out of the shotgun with Mostert. And that one goes for about 6 as he's taken down just shy of the 45.
The tackle made at the
40. So if you've been playing defense in this one, there's a little bit of the good and some bad, because they did give up the touchdown run to him earlier but shut him down otherwise.
Outside of that, you're exactly right. I would say they've contained him very well. Second down, Love. And a diving grab. I think he got that. Yes. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
A 3 yard pick.
Maximum effort, partner. Minimal gain.
Yeah, minimal gain. Looked good, though. The Lions on third down. They've been near perfect. 4 for 5 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. They'll try and run here with Mostert. And he's got the first down. Yardage before being taken down at midfield. It's a first down following a gain of 3.
First down, Lions.
On first down, they go with Mostert again. And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
4 yards on the pick.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4 yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Now a quick slant as the throw's complete. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Detroit. Terry McLaurin with touchdown number 8 on the year. And the Lions add on to their lead. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead.
13, Panthers 3. Matt Prater to kick off for Detroit.
After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23.
First and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. It's been very much a slow start for them. 3 drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is 1. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
And here's Christian McCaffrey with another run. Run CMC, as he's known in the Carolina area. Easily the most productive running back in the league last season. 2,392 yards from scrimmage. He's just so dangerous every time he gets the football.
Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off down at the 10. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number 1 on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back 7 on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
And some room for him there as he'll take this up to about the 15.
Jackson on the tackle.
The Lions will use the first of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with a little under a minute to go in this first half. And his throw here is incomplete. That was Dante Jackson, the one who got a hand in to knock it away.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent, and that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. He'll get this into the hands of Mostert, and he'll lose yardage on this one back to the 13. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number 1. The punter Bosher on now as he gets this one away. A big kick that time, 52 yards. And possession will switch hands, first and 10.
At their own 39-yard line.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. He's going to look deep for Moore, and that is incomplete. He was looking to get that one to DJ Moore, and now it's second down.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10.
58, right over there, right over there. Yeah, yeah. Mike, 58. Kill, 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 kill. 58, come on.
Brissett. Open man is Samuel, complete. He's got this to the 30 before being taken down. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain.
First and 10 at the 30-yard line.
Brissett sets to throw it. Looking for the out route, and he's got Moore. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout. As they'll stop it with 25 seconds to go here in half number one. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. From the red zone now, Brissett. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete. Christian McCaffrey, last year's catch leader among running backs, the intended receiver. And it's second down. First half. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game as we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! The Lions in the lead, and they're going to get the football first as well as the second half is underway. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. We have not seen much on offense here from either side these last few drives. We've hit a wall, so to speak.
And have hit it hard, haven't we? Because the defense is right.
The Panther rush too strong. They get there and take him down. Brian Burns in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year.
Second down.
Work to be done here on second and 16 after the sack. Working out of the gun. Love. Eluding the pressure right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
While the ultimate result was an incomplete pass, they sure looked like a well-coached team because once he got outside of the pocket, the scramble rules come into effect. And a lot of the guys who ran deep routes, they come back closer to the line of scrimmage. And the running back usually runs a check down. He took it deep, and they gave it a big shot and came up unsuccessful.
That was no third and 2. That was third and 16, but they get the conversion anyway. On first and 10, Love slings this deep from McLaurin. And this throw will be intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. And he'll take this across midfield and inside the 45. That is just what this defense was hoping for, an interception on the opening possession of this third quarter.
Obviously didn't want to surrender a touchdown and fall even farther behind. And we've gotten to know this team a little bit, haven't we? Couldn't you just see their defensive leaders telling the offensive guys, telling the quarterback, don't worry, we got you to start things off. You take it from there.
20. Open man is Robbie Anderson. And he's going to be out down inside the 20 at the 15. That one nearly 30 yards, 29 officially.
18-yard line.
Now Brissett. Forced out to his left. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line.
On the keeper.
Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
2 yards on the pickup. It's second and 8.
To throw again on second down. Brissett. Buying time to... And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Leonard Williams, the defensive tackle, getting in there for a loss of 5. And with a 3rd and 13 here, the defense in a dime look. Throwing, Brissett. Back in the end zone, could he get his feet down? No, it's incomplete.
They certainly had good starting field position on that drive, but couldn't do anything with it after 3 plays. Have to admit that that's a disappointing end to excellent field position. When that drive started, they had 6 points that they were thinking about.
So the drive stalls out inside the 15-yard line, but they do get 3.
And I've talked with enough players nowadays that when they have these types of kicks, that no one says to their guy, hey, that's just like making an extra point, piece of cake. Because the extra point is not a piece of cake anymore. But kicking a field goal from that distance, just give him confidence and let him knock it through.
This taken in about 4 yards deep. And they'll bring it out to the 25 as Agnew elects for the touchback.
25-yard line.
Offense ready to kick off their next drive. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't.
And it's intercepted. Picked off by Eli Apple. We're holding on to the lead at this stage in the second half. Those are the types of plays you really want to try and stay away from.
And when you're a rookie, keeping your focus is something that you still have to work on all the time, because there's so many distractions around you between the crowd noise and your coaches and your teammates. But the other part, you've got to learn how to finish. The 2 F's for a rookie quarterback.
They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And he's going to get it across the midfield stripe into Lion territory. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
To the 49-yard line. A gain of 2. Brings up 2nd and 8.
From just shy of midfield, Brissett. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down.
Another attempt, another incompletion. And when I look at the scoreboard and where we are in this game, it comes to mind that they have to start getting the ball in the hands of their playmakers. Throw it to the guys that maybe can take a short pass and turn it into a long gain or make people miss downfield. They've got to have points. And the guys who can put the ball in the end zone, they're the ones that need to touch the ball.
So the failure to connect on 2nd down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. To throw is Brissett. He can run for it, and he will. A nifty bit of scrambling there. 12 yards, 1st down.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a 1st down.
Give him 3 on 1st down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. 2nd and 7 operating from the 34. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And finally down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. A very solid gain of 27.
Now what we're seeing, this is much better from this offense, because so far in this game, no touchdown to this point. And what's usually a direct correlation? Very few explosive plays.
That's been their issue, not able to make that big shot downfield or break one off, but a nice game there for a first down.
Escaping the pressure, and he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Julian Okwara
picks up his second sack of the afternoon. So they've been in the red zone three times, and it's yielded just 3 points. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Ian Thomas, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Panthers are now an extra point away from tying up this game.
And that was a beautiful ball right there as he waited for his tight end to come uncovered in the end zone. So give him points for patience as well. Delivered it right where it needed to be for 6 points.
Point after, up and good. And that will tie things up at 13. All square now at 13 all as he sends this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. And last time, one play interception. So this offense, they should be fresh.
That's a good way of putting it. And I can't wait to see what they decide to do with play calling. Because a one play drive where you throw an interception, a lot of people think the very next time out, run the football, don't give them a chance.
Maybe play action?
I think maybe you go play action, show your quarterback, get a little confidence in him, and let him fling another one.
On first and 10, it's Mostert. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43.
The ball carrier.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the lot. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
Play action this time with Love. Throwing the out route and complete. That's James. And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 right at the 40. From the gun. He's going to drop this underneath to Mostert. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars. And he came through with a nice catch right there.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. From the gun, Love. And that is caught. Touchdown, Detroit. Jesse James, his first touchdown on the year. And the Lions have taken the lead. Sometimes those tight ends are a mismatch. They found the mismatch there.
And that's exactly why you want to draw up those types of plays, because coverage is just going to go to the natural guys, the guys that make the big plays on the outside. But if you work your tight end into it, that's a tough one for a defense to handle.
Tough. They couldn't handle it. It worked out for six.
Matt Prater to kick off for Detroit.
And after the touchdown, out is Prater to kick.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And now, after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. Here's a throw out wide, complete to his running back right side. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out, and by a few inches, that'll be a first down.
First and 10 at the 35-yard line.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. That was the veteran Jamie Collins busting through to make the stop.
Brought down back at the 32.
Now on second and 13. Brissett, catch here, left side, Thomas.
Brissett's pass.
They'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down.
It's a gain of nine.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
Brissett from the gun on third. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think could absorb that contact.
They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And they're going to try the screen. It's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. This is McCaffrey. And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. Tracy Walker in on the tackle.
On the pickup. Second and 6.
From the 45 on second down, Brissett. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off near the 32. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. That's now a second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. No gain on the play. It'll be second down.
No gain on the play.
Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
Takes this one across the 35 to the 36, a gain of about 4.
That's it. That's what you want. Straight ahead, positive gain. Just keep that clock ticking.
And it's third down.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far. The crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down. Now Love. It's caught, Jones. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35.
Marvin Jones.
A big gain of 31 on third down.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process. And really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
It's a gain.
I guess he was saving his best for last, so to speak. Longest run of the day coming here in the fourth quarter right there.
And that type of run makes for a better night for him and his teammates, doesn't it? To be able to produce this late in the game can lead to some big smiles and satisfaction in the locker room after this one's over.
No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. Defensively, a really solid play by Breland Speaks.
That's not an easy play for a defensive end because most of his responsibility
has him getting upfield and working, but how about his vision to see where the play was going? Crashed down inside and tackled him for a loss.
From the gun, a run with Mostert. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. Just a loss of a yard there, but it's not going to help. Now they face a third and 14. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Lions in possession of the football as we welcome you back. They're facing a critical third down now as they try to hold on to this lead. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. So fresh out of the two-minute warning, and here's another timeout taken with 1:55 remaining.
It's now fourth down.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This to make it a two-score game. And it's off the left, upright. Oh, my goodness. Heartache. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So this defense gets an assist from the goalpost, and as a result, it's going to keep them within one score.
Yeah, and that looked to be good the whole way. But that is a big break here in the fourth quarter of a football game. Now your offense needs to find a way to capitalize.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off right around the 43. McGreed, that's twice now in this fourth quarter.
As a quarterback, a lot of times you think it's all on you to make plays when you're losing. And here, the play's not there, but he throws it anyway.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Watching that play unfold and watching him complete it brought back memories of doing all those pursuit drills to make sure you don't over-pursue and let a guy get a cutback land on you. He did that very well.
You praised him on tape yesterday for the angles that he takes. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Dante Jackson picks it. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning, threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How'd things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's a guy in all the commercials now.
Right? Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Here's Brissett. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
That's going to be caught by Samuel. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Brissett. He's going to let it fly. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Daron Harmon. And he'll take it all the way up near the 30-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
A gain of two.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8.
31-yard line.
And they take a knee.
Still alive.
So this one's over. It's a win for the Detroit Lions, and they were really helped by their defense, forcing three turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of... But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had three takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So for the Lions, it's an important win in terms of staying in the postseason race as they move to 6-4. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Houston Texans. Meanwhile, for Carolina, their luck may have run out as they fall to 4-7 now in the year. And they'll be off to Minneapolis next week for a look at new U.S. Bank Stadium and a date with the Vikings. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Stepped on my arm. off-white. Okay, now wait, wait, wait. Gotta get the bag and racks every day. Don't tell me to relax, I can't, I'm a snake. Got a new press, those in the chase and a ray. Got a new wrist watch, ready, don't take time. I pull up on the off if it's talking too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit a three-point shot. Boy, this my court, got a block on lock. And I made it by the million and I'm only 19. I see water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she's saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Just do it. Hit the bag and then I flip it, watch me do it. Just do it. All the more on my wrist, going stupid. Just do it. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They're like, hold up, wait a minute, like, don't make sense to really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken, that tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep it racking my sauce. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey, hey yo. Nike check.
Yeah, I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, I turn the knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating around here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I'm with the Cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Since like 9-5, I've been eager for this. Talent on the rise, I'm consistent with this. Trophy is the prize, ain't no gimmicks with this. Okay, now what's left on them? Told you I'ma flex on them. I did it all subtle, ooh, and then I hit that exit on them. Gotta blame my faith, cause these odds ain't got nothing on them. I secured it safe, for the cradle, I ain't dropping nothing. Only when it gets exception, ain't no truce. Ain't no dub, ain't no L on my crew. Only when it gets exception on my crew. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Yeah, 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 I'ma act a fool with this. Okay, yeah, yeah, can I hit that?
Quarterback, shake and bake, make a play just like a quarterback. We ain't worrying about no formers, we ain't stating that. Running off the block, yeah, I'm something like a linebacker. I got juice like a Fanta, how you like it?
How you like it?
I'm on purple, I'm on yellow, like a Viking.
Like a Viking.
All these plays that I'm catching, I done gone crazy. I do my thing, six range, just like Tom Brady. Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped the bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunt. Call me Ty Gurley, hit the hole, then I ran it. Get money, you ain't trying to get that second flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake. I'm in the field like a Panther, I done up the standards. Like Michael Vick in Atlanta when it's time to scramble. Neck full of water, call me Black Bridgewater. Lamar Jackson, how I throw them Ravens across the border.
Hold up, you know I'm a touchdown with the sack. Run up the whole life, a running back on the play. Intercept the pack like a safety, you boy, let's shake the play. That's a flag on the play. Let's go.
Touchdown, I just scored a whole bucket. I just dropped the bag on the tag, ain't nothing. Make them throw a flag when I pass, come through stunt. Call me Ty Gurley, hit the hole, then I ran it. Get money, you ain't tryna get that second flag on the play. Hating from the sideline, a flag on the play. Like Julio with them Falcons, I just made a play. In the red zone, going strong, watch me shake and bake.
Let's go.
Let me explain what I did, can I kick it? Hold on, yeah, I got some rings and a range, can I kick it? Yeah, don't ask me a thing, how I got her, how I did it, yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast, can I kick it?
Even scouting points are earned every week. Use all of your points because a portion of the remaining points will be lost when you advance the week.
And when brother got rich again, just a little hiccup. I did be ballin' this pickup. Remember me being so bummy and being so hungry, I had to eat gristle. Ay, how did the lady go miss? Ay, how she with magic, she mixed. Met her at one of the fights and we caught a little rhythm. She caught up a friend, they kissed and we dipped it, and that's how we kicked.
Let me explain what I did, can I kick it? Hold on, yeah, I got some rings and a range, can I kick it? Yeah, don't ask me a thing, how I got her, how I did it, yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast, can I kick it? Even with a sprain, pain, can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain, can I kick it? Things ain't been the same, things have changed, can I kick it? People acting different, so I asked, can I?
Before I went live, they know what I was. Ain't no one alive that could do what I does. Need a light here just to catch my buzz. Need Sprite here just to catch my cup. Now they don't really talk about us. Now they don't really talk about love. Honestly, they ain't never seen too much. What's love to a guy with a bag? What's heart to a guy with some cash? What's pain to a guy that's mad? Said. What's broke to a guy with a mask? What's broke to a guy with a plan? I just wanna kick it, that's all I ask. Like.
Let me explain what I did, can I kick it? Hold on, yeah, I got some rings and a range, can I kick it? Yeah, don't ask me a thing, how I got her, how I did it, yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast, can I kick it? Even with a sprain, pain, can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain, can I kick it? Things ain't been the same, things have changed, can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
Hey boy, and be some, you gotta go berserk.
Okay. Sometimes you need a friend, not the ones that just show up and don't put nothing in. You know the ones that lend a hand and wanna see you win. When you come up on that lick, make sure you cut them in. And then, sometimes you need a foe, wanna keep your eyes open, keep you on your toes. You know the ones that wanna keep you where you've been before.
I can't go.
No, I can't go.
No, I can't go.
No, I can't go.
And whoa,
sometimes I need a check. Not the sneakers, but the ones that make you watch your step. Your chain, name.
It's Baltimore, Maryland. It's week 13 of the NFL on EA Sports. It's the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Dallas Cowboys.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to historic Baltimore, Maryland and M&T Bank Stadium. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game. And that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Dallas Cowboys and the Baltimore Ravens. The bye weeks are over. It's all about football all the time as we're underway here in week 13. And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. So here are the Cowboys now ready to go on offense for the first time. They'll be led out by their quarterback back in the NFL for the first time since 2016. It's Colin Kaepernick.
That was a solid performance last week, wasn't it? Two touchdowns, no interceptions, ran the team well, won the ball game. Bottom line, may not have been earth-shattering, but it didn't need to be.
A throw for Galladay is going to be intercepted. It's the former Seahawk, Richard Sherman. And they will finally bring this run back to an end, but not before he's down inside the 5-yard line at the 4. So here are the Ravens with great field position to start out. And they'll be led out by a second-round pick back in April out of Oklahoma by way of Alabama. It's Jalen Hurts.
And what he's thinking about right now is first down, let's find a way to make a big play. Because when you get a sudden change situation and that defense has to rush onto the field unexpectedly, you might catch them having a defensive breakdown, but not quite prepared.
And it was really sudden after the first play picked off. Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20, because to me, that's the magic.
And he will take it in for a Ravens touchdown. Leonard Fournette with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Ravens have taken the early lead. And the Ravens lead at 7-0.
The kick is good.
People always talk about one of his biggest strengths running the football, vision, and he found the spot there, went into the end zone.
You're exactly right about that. It wasn't just the vision, right? Once he saw the gap, decisiveness, made up his mind, and about the power to finish the play. Not only did he get good blocking, he created his own space as well.
Second drive forthcoming here for the Dallas Cowboys. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound from here?
Yeah, a little bit of humor. Gotta laugh that one off, and not the ha-ha, that was very funny, but kind of like, can you believe that just happened? Let's go out and play now. Let's just start over.
A first first carry for the former Falcon, Tevin Coleman. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
It's a loss of
the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. They fake the give. Now Kaepernick looking long for Thomas. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
Now left side on the swing pass. A nice little screen. They get 6 on first down. Charles, Thursday night game, I think a lot of teams probably say shrink the playbook somewhat. Is that correct?
I think you're right about that, because you just don't have the amount of time that you have in a normal week to put in a full playbook. So, as you said, you shrink the playbook, pick out the plays that work best for you. You know what else you're looking for?
What's that?
Who are the freshest guys coming off the last game to play on a Thursday night? Guys have a little extra pep in their step. You go to them early and often.
4 yard line.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
To Marquise Goodwin.
Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back, and he'll get it here to the 10-yard line.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover it before he gets going?
And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. Solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3. At the Cowboys' 3-yard line.
They get this out left, and he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Marquise Goodwin, his first touchdown on the year, and the Ravens will extend their lead. I'll let you do the analysis, partner, but with every touchdown pass his young quarterback throws and with the success that his team has had, I just continue to be more and more impressed.
Let's both do the analysis. Impressed, aren't we both?
Yeah.
I mean, and why shouldn't we be? We've seen him improve throughout the year. We've seen him settle in now, and you can see the confidence of the team has grown. His confidence has grown. I think that everyone around this guy feels good about what they've seen, and it's also safe for him when he's driving home to turn on Sports Talk Radio. He's okay.
Graham Gano set to kick off.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Automatic first down.
They've got good starting field position as they come up here 1st and 10 at their own 42. This is Coleman. Well, look at the numbers for Coleman in last week's game. 14 carries, 62 yards, and a touchdown.
And now that he's playing a Thursday night game, short week, you know he spent a lot of time in the trainer's room in the cold tub trying to get his legs back for this game.
Now Kaepernick throwing on 2nd down. That one caught by Tyreek Hill. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. Give him 14 on that one and a 1st down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. First carry from Mike Davis, the former Seahawk. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. A tackle there by Richard Sherman.
Let's go!
No gain.
You don't see that a ton, do you? With a cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle.
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball's moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11.
If you're a selfish player and you're throwing the ball, you're cool with the completion. Maybe not so cool with the yardage loss, though.
Yeah, you went backwards on the yardage. That kind of works like a sack for the defense there.
Yeah, it's a really big play for them, right? Able to figure it out, snip.
And this is caught inside the five. Touchdown, Cowboys.
Number 13,
James Washington. His sixth touchdown of the season. And the Cowboys draw a bit closer.
Joey Sly.
And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear nine from the receivers. That meant fly route, go. Uh-oh, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
This game back within a touchdown now as the kickoff's away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25.
Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. And it's only November, but the playoffs, we know how it works. They'll be here before you know it. If it ended today, they would be the number one seed.
And that's a great spot to be in. But I love the phrase, if it ended today. And I'll guarantee you, that's what they've discussed in their locker room, in their meeting rooms. Yeah, we know where we'd be if it ended today, but we also know it's not ending today.
Right.
So they've got to continue to play the type of ball that put them in the spot where they're number one in their conference.
Trying to get it to Jackson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the all-pro corner, Josh Norman. And he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. And on that one, with six defensive backs, did he need to be more careful throwing the football? I mean, I guess obviously in hindsight he did, but...
Yeah, hindsight, but even in foresight, when you got six defensive backs on the field, you just know you're going to get multiple coverages. You're never sure what you're going to see. But the biggest one is you don't have much reaction time for your receivers to go get the football because those guys, they're the best cover guys on the field. They go get it. And on that play, they took it the other way for 6 points.
Now Joey Sly for the point after. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go-around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. Contrary on that last possession, though.
The running play there, going to get 11 as they get a quick first down.
That's good for a Baltimore Raven.
Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give them the yardage that they needed. They really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line.
On the stop. It's a gain of 5. Brings up 2nd and 5 at the 41-yard line.
Pretty entertaining start. 14 all to score on EA Sports.
14-14.
second down. Here's Jalen Hurts. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
I have to give some credit to the defender on that one. He read all of his keys perfectly and got a great break on the ball and able to force that incompletion.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Now Leonard Fournette. And he's got the first down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. Third down turns to first with that five-yard pickup.
I definitely like the play call. You don't expect it on third and five, third and six, do you? You expect a pass play. Had a little courage there to call the run, and boy, they were successful.
A couple of first downs on the drive already as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. Here's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And he'll be down at the 46. So they go from one 46 to the other on a pickup of eight. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Nine Hines, his first carry. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Not too many more ideal situations at second and two in order to try and pick up a first down. They ran it and picked it up.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. That's complete to a speedy wideout, Goodwin. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 10 yards there, good enough for a Raven first down. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. From the gun, it's Hurts. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. The coverage good that time by Kendall Fuller. Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. They run with Hines. He'll get the first down and more inside the 20. And he'll finally be taken down at the 18. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
Partner, in our years together, we've never really run into a player that's admitted a doubt or a lack of confidence, right? But right now, I'm just wondering about that interior line because on defense, they're starting to get manhandled at the point of attack. Do they have it in them to figure a way to reverse the tide? Because right now, they're running the ball at will.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now Fournette. And they'll get him down right around the 16. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and eight coming up.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. Gets this one to Juszczyk. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. Give him seven on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
It's now fourth down and one.
They'll run with a fullback, Juszczyk. And he has the first down before he's tackled at the five. So give him the first down, first and goal after a pickup of four. And the decision to go for it pays off. They'll try and run for it with Fournette. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore. Leonard Fournette with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Ravens have taken the lead. And always a good first half when you can hit pay dirt twice.
And it never hurts to have that good feeling as the game moves on. Just think about halftime. If that's all he gets, he'll just sit there at the half and think, all right, two already. I can get some more. And he'll be encouraging his offensive line to create some space.
The touchdown here to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Tyreek Hill making his way back out towards the huddle. They've got to be thinking, how can we get him a little bit more involved here? Second quarter, you're down, and really, he's been out of the mix.
I would agree with that, and oftentimes you hear, well, we're just taking what the defense is giving us. But sometimes that's just not good enough. Sometimes you have to take what you want, and that means getting him the football.
Yeah, so far just a single catch in this game. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. First play of the drive goes the wrong way. Here's second and 12.
At the 23-yard line.
Here's Coleman. Now a loose football. Coleman lost it, and it's picked up by the Ravens. And they're going to take over right there at the 22-yard line. Not the trend he wanted to start the season with, a fumble lost in both weeks 1 and 2. Now, it's not a disaster, but certainly not what he was looking for.
Got to get that fixed, because otherwise he shows up on every scouting report. I remember sitting in defensive rooms and hearing the scouting report from my coaches, and if someone had a particular problem carrying the ball and holding on to it, that was noted. Hey, make sure you get a little extra attention to him. Get after the football. He's dropped it the last couple of games.
Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. He'll have a first down inside the 10. And he gets it all the way down to the 3. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
Leonard Fournette, the ball.
And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. They'll try to punch it in with Fournette. And he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
That didn't just feel like good defense there. That felt like pride, didn't it? He's already gotten into the end zone twice, trying to get there for a third time. No one likes to have the hat trick against them.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal. That's out to the left and complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Marquise Goodwin with 2 touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Ravens will add on to their lead. And there was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Gano now to add the extra point. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. So that drive, 4 plays. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run.
Graham Gano set to kick off.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Out comes the Ravens defense now as they get ready for the next possession. And a big reason they have the lead right now, as we see on the screen, they're 3 turnovers.
And how about the emotion now that the defensive team is generating for the entire...
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But there's also something to challenging your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. From the gun, it's Kaepernick. And it's complete. He gets this one to Washington. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards. Now it's third and 5.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
From the gun on third down, Kaepernick. And that will be incomplete.
That could be the stop this defense needed to get them back on track. They've been pretty well dissected by the offense here in the first half. After that possession, now they know that they can compete with this offense.
A big boot that time. 57 yards the official distance. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. Leonard Fournette making his way back out there. He's been effective so far over the 40-yard mark here in the second quarter. Don't forget about those guys up front, though. They've been effective, too.
The leverage game has been in their favor. They've been the ones who've been able to bend their knees, drop their hips, and get a little bit lower than the guys on the other side of the football, and they've moved them out of the way for the runner.
Sometimes that's tough for those big fellas.
Not an easy thing for them to do.
23 yards on the play.
Raven.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. Man open, it's Goodwin. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Flush to his right. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
On the keeper. Incomplete.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. They'll throw now on the final play. Going deep downfield for Ross. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. So we're at halftime here in the Inner Harbor with the hometown Ravens on top. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. We'll get back to you and CD in a minute. First, it's time to take a look at what we've got coming your way this weekend in the NFL. As far as the early...
And okay, so much for our halftime break. Apparently, we're going to get right back to it. The Ravens ready to receive it, and they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half. Returning it, John Ross. And he's able to get it across the 20 to the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a first down.
36-yard line.
51-yard line.